the heart of Formula One, a place we love, but also a place of painful memory. There are days that leave scars. It began here. Friday practice, Rubens Barrichello, my driver, had a most appalling accident at 160 miles an hour. Ruby was unconscious, but escaped with nothing more than a broken nose. That was modern Formula One. Big accident, no harm done. But the next day in qualifying, that's when it all changed.
Ratzenberger lost control at some 190 miles an hour and went straight into a concrete barrier, which claimed the life of the popular Austrian.
Saturday turned agonizingly into Sunday, May the 1st, 1994.
Senna, my goodness, I just saw him punch off
the greatest motor racing drivers, Ayrton Senna, has died after a crash at this afternoon's San Marino Grand Prix in Italy. He was 34.
He was the hero, ultimate racing driver, right up to the moment that he lost his life.
It was shocking that it was him, because it's like the sun falls from the sky. He was kind of above everything.
The body of Ayrton Senna arrived at Sao Paulo Airport in the early morning.
Senna was the pride of his country, the number one popular hero, and is being mourned as such.
It was just unbelievable. It was just like a state funeral.
You could see what it meant for the whole country.
If he'd known how his life was going to unfold, he wouldn't have changed anything.
It cannot be sounding true, but I start with 4 years old in go-kart, and that is plenty of time to get Formula One, if I will get there.
I first came across Ayrton Senna da Silva at the beginning of 1982. I was so impressed that I offered him a free drive in our Formula 3 car. I still have the sheet from that test day. 54.07, 53.9, unbelievably fast times. I tried so hard to sign him for the following year. Sadly, that wasn't to happen.
He'd won every championship in cars that he'd entered, and then he moved up to F3, and he was straight away on the pace.
And taking the checkered flag, Ayrton Senna wins for the 10th time this season, and he is naturally overjoyed.
I already knew of his talent, and offered to pay for his career in return for an option. I was somewhat surprised when he said no.
When talking about him driving in Formula One, I was pretty excited. I knew that he was a good prospect. I won't pretend I knew how good.
When it's wet, it equalises the field more. And Matt Tolman was a notoriously terrible car to drive.
The wet is where the talent shows, and Senna is very, very talented indeed.
It goes without saying they can drive a car fast. You sort of expect that. It's what they can add to that. He just had this innate ability to know what was going on.
And Senna challenging for that second place, and he's taken it.
Dragged that car up the grid and finished second.
Cross has won with Senna second.
He's not about to be world champion this year. He will undoubtedly be world champion in the future.
1 year with Tolman, and then he was gone to Lotus. Now he could compete with the best.
This usually totally unflappable Brazilian is, for once, absolutely beside himself.
Soon he was changing team colours again into the red and white of McLaren.
He was passionate about driving, almost certainly derived more pleasure from it than any driver I knew.
He explained it sometimes. He could put everything in slower motion than all of us, so he had more time to put every corner into perfection.
Consistently fastest, lap after lap.
He was very, very, very special behind that wheel, and he wasn't aggressive with the wheel at all. He just knew how to carry the momentum through the corner.
That onboard of him around Monaco, things like that, you know, they are truly special things to watch.
He says, out of the corner, my engine did not feel very good. So I changed the mixture a little bit richer, and it was then going to the casino, I really felt an improvement. And then in the end, I tried even a step more, and it was even better again. I couldn't change one time the mixture in this lap, and he was playing around and put the car at the same time in pole position. And this is why he was just better than all of us.
The second chicane is becoming bumpy, and then he's like you.
Ayrton was the first guy I met who wasn't using 100% of his mental capacity to drive the car. There was this capacity that allowed him to analyse and tell you what he thought was going on and allowed you to then try and make the car better. It really was something special.
As I position the car into the apex, then I'm no longer going like this.
He had all these sheets of every driver, every lap. He was going after Sunday, winning the race, and going through every lap of every driver.
The period with McLaren, 6 years, it was an extremely dominant period, bearing in mind that we had highly talented drivers in the other car.
Ayrton Senna was such an icon in our sport, and I certainly felt that. So much so that I offered him 50% of Jordan Grand Prix, free of charge, to come and join me, because I believed, truthfully, that with him by my side, it would be a much stronger team, much more professional, much more successful, and much better off financially. He was the partner I desperately needed. In his early years in Formula 3, I'd seen a ruthlessness in Ayrton. No question, he felt he had a God-given right to win. Win at all costs. A reckless self-belief.
Senna sprints away, but Alain Prost takes the lead. It's happened. Alain Prost has taken the advantage. Senna is trying to go through on the inside, and it's happened immediately. This is amazing.
Yes, and that makes Ayrton Senna world champion this year.
Ayrton has a small problem. He thinks that he can't kill himself, because he believes in God and things like this, and I think that's very dangerous.
He was an animal in the car. He was fighting. He was, people say he was reckless, he was dangerous or whatever, you know, sometimes it was too much.
You either commit yourself as a professional racing driver that is designed to win races, or you come second, or you come third, or you come fifth. And I'm not designed to come third, fourth, or fifth. I race to win.
Ayrton was a charming person. He was very intelligent. And inside, he was tough.
He's a very emotional Latin man, very emotional in the car. He wanted to do everything. He's so strong. And then on the other side, he was very philosophically, very quiet, very, very nice, very gentle.
1992 in Spa, Eric Comas in a crash. Ayrton risks his life, stops and runs across the track. He turns off the engine to prevent a fire. Eric says it saved his life. The cruel Senna, the compassionate Ayrton.
I only saw the compassionate man, the man with a huge amount of presence when he walked in the door. You know, when Ayrton walked in, you knew he was there and you wanted to talk to him. He was an engaging guy to talk to.
Before qualifying, he always used to sit in the motorhome to read a couple of lines in the Bible. But you know me, I was opening the Playboy and I said, Ayrton, you won't come over and read a little bit the Playboy? And he had a laugh, but he kept reading, and then he went out and went to ball position. So sometimes I thought I'm reading the wrong stuff maybe, but I didn't want to change.
By 1991, he was the youngest ever three-time world champion. But then 2 years without success, he was on the move again to the now successful Williams team.
Unfortunately, the Williams of that year at the start of the year wasn't a very good car, and Ayrton's determination and confidence and his ability meant he was, I think, driving that car harder than it was really capable of.
And Senna's lost it. That just shows you how hard Senna was trying, and he's pushed himself right to a mistake now.
And so we come back here, Imola, May the 1st, 1994.
He was a worried man, certainly going into that that Imola weekend. There's a lot going on. Roland's accident was something that deeply upset him.
He wasn't so happy. He was talking to GPD all the time and seeing, you know, that safety has to grow and this and that.
He was far more quiet than normal, I'd say. You could see he was thinking all the time.
I remember on Sunday walking together with him to the driver's meeting. And he says, Gerd, next week I call you, we need to meet, we need to talk how we can improve safety.
It's warm, track conditions are ideal. And there's no disguising the fact that after two non-finishes, today is the day that Ayrton Senna really must make his first move in this 1994 World Championship. Now! And Senna boils away!
For me, when the flag dropped, he was completely focused. I don't think any of that background stuff contributed to how he drove the car.
Senna! My goodness! What on earth happened there?
When I was just coming out of Tamburello, he was just crashing into the wall, and I looked and I saw him and I said, well, it's okay, it's good angle.
When we saw the accident, we thought, this is a bad accident, but it'll be okay.
We couldn't see very much, and we were getting so many conflicting messages. All I can really remember is the noise, to be honest. The damn sirens going off.
I had this feeling like the soul is going out. It's just, it's over.
Yeah, I mean, and to this day, I really don't know what happened. Such a loss. Such a waste.
A measure of the man. After the impact here in Tamburello, they found in his car an Austrian flag, which he was going to wave for Roland Ratzenberger at the end of the race. He certainly was a genius, but that genius died here in Imola, first weekend of May 1994. Yes, there are places and dates that leave a scar.
No one knew the man more than I. And he's a good guy.
After 10, 15, 20 years, you realize what kind of person still is, you know. It's nice and also makes me proud a little bit, I must say.
A superman, super dedicated to his family, a super driver, and a super friend.
He was definitely up there in the very, very top bracket of the very top drivers in the history of modern Formula One.
If not the greatest, then very arguably one of the greatest.
I'll never know whether he's the quickest. Now, wouldn't it be great to get all these guys together and have a big race in heaven, maybe?
All the guys I experienced include Michael Schumacher, include Vettel. There was another layer, and there was just one guy in, that was Ayrton Senna.